change. Do something nice.
I was alone and afraid because I didn't know what was wrong with me.
I was very frightened. I didn't know what was happening. I didn't know who was my doctor. I didn't know who was the midwife, who was a student.
For many women, labor is a time of fear, pain, and loneliness. Women no longer experience childbirth surrounded by their family and community. Instead, in hospital, despite much advanced technology, they labor alone, emotionally abandoned. They may even be subjected to physical and emotional abuse.
And they put masking tape on their girl's mouth.
Lots of verbal abuse. Then there's a level of physical abuse where the thighs have to be snapped open, either with a pinch or a slap, or they use the instruments to just snip you a little bit, so you jump open.
I had the baby and the treatment wasn't good at all because they kept telling me that I shouldn't cry. It's not their fault that I have to be pregnant. I mean, I should cry to my boyfriend, not to them, because they didn't make me pregnant.
They started getting everything ready for theater, at which point a small doctor, I call him small because he was short, walked in and he said to me, "What would you like to say to me?" I said, "I really need to push." And the nurses were going, "No, she can't push. She still hasn't dilated 8 centimeters even. She doesn't know what she's talking about. Quiet, take the gas." And they put a gas mask on me and I had to shut up. And he said to me, he was the first doctor, in fact, and I was examined about 7 or 8 times by different people. He was the first doctor actually came and said, "Do you mind if I do an internal examination? I am Dr. So-and-so." Before that, it was just like, "Hello, pleased to meet you." And it was very intrusive. It was very offensive. I felt very exploited. I felt very invaded. I felt very incompetent.
So I was left in the room for the whole night with that parcel that they left for me. It was my baby. I kept on looking at the baby because I wanted to see, it's my baby. I wanted to hold it, but I couldn't. And I was alone in the room. I wished they could take me somewhere.
Omunye ubone ukuthi lo usengazala nanini, omunye ngamthola e-toilet. Escrima khona kudala bamiyekile. Ampura tholela umntana layo, ngagijima ngabiza enye inesi yayingconywana yona. Ukuthi hayi awuze uzosiza. Ampura bam wengasakwazi nokusukuma la. Bamsusa la sebamgugile. Ntshele. Ampura umntana amtholele toilet ingasi yimi seyakhuna la toilet yakhanula. He? Akusikahle ngempela, akusikahle. Abanye bayakwazi ngempela. Awomnyathi aya uyarasa angifake themomitha emlonyeni. Thula.
From the healthcare workers' point of view, frustrations are many.
The patients, you find now that we have the influx of patients coming from other countries, and the most important thing, that the problem that we really have is a communication problem. You find the patient doesn't understand you, you do not understand the patient.
Mostly we short of staff, and we have to have a lot of patience because of the long hours, and we're very busy.
The red tape, you have to, there's always a way of communicating. You can't just do things on your own. You have to get to management. You have to get to the superintendent. Before getting to the superintendent, there is the area manager, there is the deputy director, and there's always, it's never, let's put it this way, a thing of that you can communicate directly. You always have to get a message from the top flowing down, coming to you, giving you instructions at time.
These frustrations may result in a form of nursing care that is not ideal.
You find those that, I don't know, is it due to pressure of work, or is it just your personality or makeup, that you do find that they are not too nice with the patients.
Then the midwife's whole approach towards the patient can become abusive. She may hit the patient or ignore the patient, and the patient can deliver on her own in a labor ward. Or a doctor cannot be available, and as a result of frustration of not getting a doctor, she can take it out on the patient. And it could have very dire consequences. Baby could die, mother could have complications during labor, or because of the setup in a labor ward.
You know in maternity that you always raise your voice because you're worried anything could happen. And then you find yourself saying, push mommy, push, and you pushing with the mommy, but not to hurt or to really do, but it's just that you become anxious with this mommy. You can't lose this baby at the moment.
We ridicule them, yell at them.
Severe staff shortages, overloaded maternity services, financial constraints, and cumbersome bureaucracy all result in a situation of maternity services in which women have little or no support during labor.
You know, I needed somebody to be near me, to tell me that it's going to be all right, even though maybe it wasn't going to be okay. But you know, you needed somebody to be near you and to talk to you, somebody you know, somebody familiar, or somebody to talk to you.
To care, to praise, to comfort, and to reassure this woman.
When women come to a hospital or a clinic to give birth, they do have the advantage of medical care. But what they lose when they move from their homes is that support from other women in their family or in their community who would normally be with them right through labor and care for them and support them.
Labor support is a very important thing, and over the time that a woman's in labor, she develops a trust in you and a camaradeship with you, and sometimes more than anybody else, you could get to that patient where nobody else could.
The concept of labor support is not merely a fashionable idea, but has been researched extensively internationally and here in South Africa.
What we found in our research at Coronation, we had two groups of women. The one group had been randomly allocated to have the labor supported during labor, and the other group had had the normal hospital care during labor. And we followed them for 6 weeks and even longer after the birth. And what we found is those that had had the labor support, firstly, were less anxious, they had less anxiety, they had better self-esteem, better sense of their own ability to have coped with labor and to cope with being a mother. They had more positive attitudes towards their children, their babies. They had more positive child-rearing practices, and they were able to breastfeed more successfully, and fewer of them developed depression, which is a big problem we see amongst women after birth.
In our busy hospitals and clinics, it is often a challenge to provide a support person for a woman in labor. The lack of privacy, where women often labor two or three women in one cubicle, is an additional problem, particularly if a woman were to be accompanied by her husband or partner. Due to these difficulties, it is important to explore different options for labor support.
Many different people may give support during labor, perhaps someone from the woman's family, but it seems that one of the best categories of people who give support is women from the community who have a special feeling that they would like to do this kind of work and are prepared to come into a hospital or a clinic as a volunteer and be with women during labor as a supportive person.
This should be a mature person who has love, who shows compassion, who cares about people. This is the sort of person that you need.
I believe women need women in situations like that. A sister, or a good friend, or a mother-in-law, or a mother is very helpful in situations like that because they've been there. They are a woman, they understand that same pain.
Somebody who's got a lot of patience, a lot of understanding, a lot of compassion, a lot of empathy for that person, and someone who can stand back and is quite ready to be called upon when they're needed and not to be offended if the woman is a little bit grumpy towards them. It's just all within the nature of birth.
At Coronation Hospital, in our labor ward, we have a doula program. The word doula is a Greek word which means a woman or a lay person who comes in to support women in labor. The difficulty has been that it's always hard to implement any new program into a labor ward without experiencing some administrative difficulties and also some difficulties with the staff who are maybe resistant to any form of change. However, I have to say that here at Coronation Hospital, we've basically been able to implement the doula system with almost no problems. And now we're sitting with a situation where both the labor ward staff and the patients are all very happy with the doula system, and we really feel that it's a success in our labor ward.
I work as a volunteer, labor volunteer. I come in to come and support the mothers, you know, whilst they're in labor. Being a doula makes me feel, you know, that I'm needed in the society, especially the hospital situation, where I can help the mothers. Look, I always feel, you know, when you're older and you have no responsibilities anymore, you can put something back into the community.
I feel needed. I feel special because they appreciate, they really appreciate what we're doing to them, what I'm actually doing for them. Yeah?
Many hospitals and clinics hearing about the labor support project may feel interested but daunted at the thought of setting up such a program in hospitals and clinics where lack of resources is a long-standing problem. The advantage of a labor support program is the minimal costs involved. We implemented the program in our hospital by firstly inviting all women in labor to bring their own support person with them. Those women who were without a companion were offered the support of a doula. We recruited volunteers to be doulas from the local community through advertisements in the newspaper, through churches and community organizations. We were looking for women with compassion and who had experience of childbirth. Once the women responded, the concept of a doula was fully discussed with them. They were screened and training in the form of role plays was conducted. Discussions with the labor ward staff and administration resolved any other problems, and the doulas were launched onto the labor ward. Cooperation from staff and administration and volunteers from the community requires much motivation but little money. This is a practical reason why we feel a labor support program can be implemented in any maternity service.
We hope that this project would be implemented in all the hospitals in South Africa. We also hope that this project will be taken away to African countries, because what has happened is that with the medical intervention, it's taken the woman away from her home place. Women used to deliver in a traditional way at homes with their mothers or with caregivers around them.
The idea of the future of the nation relating to the well-being of the children is a very important one. There seems to be a situation in which the care women receive in labor translates into the care they give to their babies and the development of their families in the future.
A woman who is supported in labor will be a happier mother. She will be able to remember her labor as a positive and special life event and move on to build a strong and happy relationship with her child. This, in turn, will build the family unit and strengthen the whole community. The labor support program will enable some of the workload of the labor ward staff to be alleviated, thereby making their work happier and in turn changing the labor ward from a place of great stress into an area of great joy. Once implemented, the labor support project will mean that a situation will be reached in all our maternity services where women will no longer labor alone, but instead will labor in an atmosphere of continual support.